Inquisition must certainly seem an audacious idea to the Grand Clerics. We hope to convince them it is a necessity.
If Fiona and her malcontents are joining us as allies, we need to be prepared. Abominations are inevitable. Cullen doesn't have enough Templars to handle incidents. Some of the rank and file need to be trained.
The last thing we need are abominations running amok.
I knew you would have a proper grasp of the situation. I'll have a word with Cullen. We are reliant on his people, absolutely. There has never been a greater threat to mages than the breach. Until it is closed, no one is safe.
You have a low opinion of your fellow mages.
It's not so much an opinion as grasping the obvious. Magic is dangerous, just as fire is dangerous. Anyone who forgets this truth gets burned.
I think that's right.
You're preaching to the choir, Vivian.
Tell me something. You said once that you wanted to change things. What future would you build for mages?
Gosh, I really don't know. Because freedom doesn't necessarily seem to suit them. But the circles didn't work either. So I guess maybe this is a medium.
Mages shouldn't be kept out of the Chantry. Who knows the dangers of magic better than a mage?
A curious idea. Such twists and turns your mind takes. It's something to consider, my dear.
Yeah, okay. I think I like this. Okay, I want to speak to Dorian now. And maybe Solas.
So we have gained the mages. Excellent. They should be able to seal the breach. You are certain you experienced time travel. Could it have been an illusion? A trick of the Fade?
I don't think so, and Dorian's pretty sure.
Dorian was sure. Impossible as it seems.
What an amazing gift. It is vital the Inquisition succeed to avoid the future you witness.
Did I see him there? That's not true. It doesn't matter. Of course it matters. Yeah, I guess I'll say this.
I'm surprised you're not more interested in your own future.
I know enough. If that future happened, then I, and Cassandra, Cullen and the rest, failed to stop this Elder One. Speaking of which, you should ready yourself.
For?
This Elder One. You have now interfered with his plans twice. Once at the Temple of Sacred Ashes, and now again at Redcliffe. A being who aspires to godhood is unlikely to ignore such an affront.
Good point there, Solas. Hey, Dorian. What's up?
The Inquisition supports free mages. What's next? Elves running Halamshiral? Cows milking farmers?
Do you disagree?
I take it you don't agree.
On the contrary, I approve. Heartily. I do wonder if you've considered what this support of yours will do. For mages in general, I mean. The Inquisition is seen as an authority. You've given southern mages license to, well, be like mages back home.
What would be wrong with that exactly?
Nothing, at first. Thing is, the Imperium was once just like the Sun. Templars, proper circles, all that rot. Then it changed by inches. Not that this is reason to oppress us. Still, my hope. homeland should be a cautionary tale, not a source of inspiration.
It occurs to me that I barely know anything about you.
Beyond my being a mage from Davinta, you mean?
Beyond that, yes.
And beyond my being so charming and well-dressed, which is obvious to anyone.
If you say so.
You certainly think highly of yourself.
It's true. I could be more modest, but I'd be lying. Now, what was I talking about? Ah, yes, me. I am the scion of House Parvus, a product of generations of careful breeding and the repository of its hopes and dreams. Naturally, I despised it all. The lies, the scheming, the illusions of supremacy. That's Tevinter in a nutshell, isn't it? Needless to say, my family was not happy with my choices.
Why would your family be upset with your choices?
Because I rejected their idyllic plan. If they had their way, by now I'd be married to some unlucky girl from a powerful family. We'd live in luxurious despair, despising each other as I waited to take my father's place in the magisterium. I declined the honor, and thus it's best I'm far from home. Less of an embarrassment that way, you see.
I'm getting the impression that you don't care much for your homeland.
On the contrary, I care for my homeland a great deal. There's so much potential. Sadly, we squander it. We refuse to acknowledge how far we've fallen because pretending is easier. We pretend the Canary can be beaten. We pretend that we're superior to everyone, even our own people. Not everyone feels that way. I don't. Sadly, we're the minority.
It just seems... so much of what you say about the Imperium is entirely negative.
It might sound that. For all our faults, my people have many virtues. We are laden with history and culture. Tevinter is where Thedas truly began, remember? We treasure our past and preserve it. You can walk down a side street and find nothing built during the modern ages. And despite appearances, we care deeply about everything. We have no reserve, not in war and not in love. If I truly believed my homeland was beyond all hope, I wouldn't miss it so much.
What did you mean by generations of careful breeding?
The great families of Tevinter don't have children. They refine traits, weed out the undesirable, and promote the rest. My mother was chosen for my father because magic runs strongly in her blood. Never mind that they loathed each other. They wanted a son who could become Archon to make House Parvus the envy of the Imperium. Cautionary tale that you should be careful what you wish for.
Why remain with the Inquisition? Why not go back to Tevinter?
I'm not exactly welcome back home. Not that it matters. I'm quite accustomed to being a pariah. It adds to my charm. I can do more for Tevinter here. If the Venatori succeed, it'll set my homeland back 1,000 years. I'm sure some magisters would disagree.
I think I've heard enough.
That's too bad. I never tire of talking about myself.
I'd like to ask you about Tevinter.
Ah, yes. Everyone outside the Imperium always seems quite fascinated by it. Probably why they come up with so many ridiculous tales. Flying cows over Minrathus. That's madness. All right, that one's actually true, but the cows didn't have wings. I digress. Anything in particular you wanted to know?
Cows?
It seems strange that an entire empire would be ruled by mages.
I find it strange that your mages don't rule anything at all. Actually, the fiction in the Imperium is that mages don't rule. The Magisterium rules. That magisters are all mages is considered a convenient technicality.
What is the Magisterium, exactly?
the upper house of the Imperial Senate, and the only part worth having a seat on. Those seats are split among the circles of Magi, the Chantry, and the Major families. All Mages now. It's odd that outside the Imperium, you use Magister like it applies to every Tevinter Mage.
So, how about you?
If you're not a Magister, then what are you called? No special title.
I'm an Altus, which is almost as good as a Magister, depending on who you ask.
And that is?
I've never heard of an Altus.
Upper class. Those families who trace descent from the Dreamers, the first prophets of the old gods. If you're a mage and you're not Altus, then you're later. Lower class. If you're not a mage at all, you're Soperati. That's everyone else. We do love our fancy words.
I thought the Archon ruled over the Imperium.
Well, yes. Technically, he can overrule laws passed by the Magisterium, but that never happens. Even so, he gets to appoint new Magisters, which means all the families vie madly for his favor. Thus, the Archon gets invited to all the parties. The truest path to Tevinter influence, let me tell you.
If it's a fiction, that means mages do rule then.
Yes, and no. Let me put it this way. Mages do rule, but not all mages are equal. If you're not from the right family, chances are you don't rule anything. Maybe you're even a slave. The idea that anyone could be a mage, however, keeps the masses placated.
Can anyone be a mage?
Technically. The potential runs mostly in bloodlines, but it's been known to happen. More importantly, commoners believe it can. Tevinter legend is chock full of mage heroes from humble origins. So they hold out hope. Someday my son or my son's son will be a mage. Someday. Poor sods don't realize that means he'll be a quaestor at the arse end of the Hundred Pillars, at best.
Being a quaestor isn't a good thing.
I imagine the average non-mage likes to think so. Counting numbers and shuffling papers all day is better than many occupations after all. If you're a second-class citizen among a pack of piranha, however, your outlook changes.
Let me ask you something else.
Of course.
I'm wondering if the Imperium would be a useful ally.
I think you'd be more concerned whether or not they'd support the Venatori. They won't. They'll disavow all knowledge of dangerous cultists. Secretly, many Magisters will rejoice at the idea. And if the South falls to chaos in the meantime, all the better.
It would be in the Imperium's best interest to help. Surely it could use allies.
I think the Imperium gave up on the idea of allies a long time ago. We've been fighting the Canary for what? 200 years off and on? It's a point of pride that we go it alone. They'll sneer at the South behind their silk handkerchiefs and say, you've had it easy for far too long. Let's not forget that the Inquisition seems to be an arm of the Orlesian Chantry. Anathema so far as they're concerned.
We're not part of the Chantry. The Chantry opposed the Inquisition's formation.
You think that matters? Don't be silly. The Herald of Andraste. Your very title smacks of the Southern Chantry. You may as well be a heathen. I think they're far more frightened what you'll do if you succeed.
There's an Imperial Chantry, isn't there? With its own divine.
You people aren't supposed to talk about the Black Divine, are you? If you mention him outside the Imperium, people make that face, like you're urinating in public. But yes, we do have the Chantry, or a version of it. Night and day comparing it to you.
Is the Imperial Chantry so different from ours?
Not in theory. The main difference is in the whole magic is meant to serve man, not rule over him business. Back home, ruling the unwashed masses is serving them, for the good of the Imperium. Perhaps it started with good intentions, but these days it's academic. The circles are in command.
There are circles of Magi in the Imperium.
We don't have dismal little mage
their academies, prestigious ones. We have Templars as well, but they don't cancel spells or whatever your Templars do. They're soldiers. They watch for abuse of magic, yes, but only those who are weak or who fall out of favor get dealt with. Mostly they enforce the Magisterium's edicts. The Chantry smiles and nods from the sidelines.
Do you really call him the Black Divine?
We don't call him that, oh no. In the Imperium, he's the true divine. The woman sitting on the Sunburst throne is some backwater pretender. It all stems from a disagreement over Andraste. Marvelous.
Why would they disagree over Andraste?
It's not my field of expertise, but the Imperium believes Andraste was a mortal woman. A mage. Down south, they say, no, she's the bride of the Maker, ascended to his side, divine providence, a blah blah blah. We feel better believing Andraste was one of us. Makes executing her less damning, you see. So we elected a man as divine, the south declared war, and we've been feuding cousins ever since.
So, the Imperial Divine is always a man?
All the better. Think there aren't a number of female magisters who bristle at that. Why can't they be divine after all? Same reason you never see a man on the Sunburst throne. Because that's how it's always been done. Excellent reasoning.
Do you consider yourself Andrastian?
Ah. The big question. It might surprise you that I do consider myself Andrastian. I simply do not believe the Chantry. It is a relic, whether back home or here in the south. Something from a bygone age desperately clinging to relevance. It's not an opinion that makes me popular.
Hmm. You know, my character might not, but I actually agree with that.
I share your opinion, actually.
That's not surprising, considering what the Inquisition represents. I'll say this. I may not believe in the Chantry, but I believe in you.
In me?
That the Maker sent you, whether through Andraste or fate. Cassandra is not wrong. You are what we needed most at the moment we needed it. That's what they will say in ages to come.
You don't seem like the religious sort. To be honest.
If you define religious as sitting in a chantry and listening to a blithering hen tell you how to live, then no. If you define it as believing in the possibility that something larger than yourself exists, then yes. By all means, the world is bigger than I, even bigger than you. It laughs at all the things we think we know. The Maker doesn't need me to believe. The thought of no one at all watching out for us is too frightening.
Let me ask you something else.
So many questions.
Just how often is blood magic used there?
Oh, not at all.
Not at all?
That's what any magister would tell you. They'd be convincingly offended by the notion, too. Of course, what people call blood magic here, what we consider blood magic, are two different things.
What's considered actual blood magic in Tevinter?
Blood magic isn't inherently dangerous. Using your own blood or that of a willing participant, what's the harm? The problem is that what's permitted only gets you so much power. And what if you need more? You always need more. That's where we get into sacrifices and demon summoning. None of that is done. Not officially. Behind closed doors, it's a different story. Real blood magic can give you an edge, a leg up against your opponents. It's safe to assume that any mage of rank does it. The rest are quietly shut out of power, to put it bluntly.
You'd think the Templars would object.
I imagine they did, long ago. Once, their investigations might have been sincere. Then their balls were cut off. Too inconvenient. Nowadays, only the friendless are accused.
most of them probably innocent.
There must be some mages who oppose this.
Of course. I do. And I'm not entirely alone. Occasionally, there'll be a magister who makes noise. And then the reform talk begins. All very patriotic. Meanwhile, that magister will be quietly shunned. Chances are, surprise, it's learned he was a Maleficar all along. Most learn to keep quiet. Me? I enjoy the allure of pariahhood.
Anyone who talks about the Imperium mentions slavery. It's the center of the slave trade.
Ah. That is true.
And did you have slaves?
Not personally, but my family does and treats them well. Honestly, I never thought much about it until I came south. Back home, it's how it is. Slaves are everywhere. You don't question it. I'm not even certain many slaves do.
Well, we don't have slaves in the south.
In the south, you have alienages, slums, both human and elven. The desperate have no way out. Back home, a poor man can sell himself. As a slave, he could have a position of respect, comfort, and could even support a family. Some slaves are treated poorly, it's true. But do you honestly think inescapable poverty is better?
At least they're free. They don't have slavery forced on them.
You think people choose to be poor and oppressed? I doubt it. I don't know what it's like to be a slave, true. I never thought about it until I saw how different it was here. But I suspect you don't know either. Nor should you believe that every tale of Tevinter excess is the norm.
That's all I wanted to know.
Fair enough.
Have you gone to see Alexius yet? He's in the cells.
Not yet, no. I saw him before they locked him up. He looked despondent, broken. Not the man I remember, nor the one I want to. I suppose the Inquisition will judge him eventually. I wonder if there's any chance they'll show him mercy. He hardly deserves it, but for Felix's sake. I can't help hoping there's something left of the man I once knew.
Didn't I have a... Yep. Grenades! Ah, we need some more Blood Lotus. And some wasps. Oh my god, that's funny.
Sigrid can get that for you, sir.
Let me know if you need anything.
What do you have to say, Varric?
The Mage Rebellion joins the Inquisition. I've got to admit, that's a twist I didn't see coming. One thing you saw in the future worries me. I mean, it was all bad. But Red Lyrium and Ferelden infecting people and growing out of them, that's bad. Finding more of it really punches a hole in my Red Lyrium at the temple was a coincidence theory.
How long does it take for Red Lyrium to grow? How fast can it spread?
It took years to infect people in Kirkwall, but no one there was actually ingesting the stuff. This Elder One managed to take the worst thing I can think of and make it worse. That's an accomplishment.
We can't leave a single piece of that Lyrium out in the wild.
I'm with you on that. I've got people trying to find out where the red stuff came from. I think maybe we should make that a priority. But that's enough doom and gloom. You just won a big victory for the Inquisition. What are you going to do to celebrate?
Well, move on to what's next.
We can't know what's coming. Best not to get too comfortable.
I can't disagree with that. But maybe you should try to relax while you can. Things should be calm around here for at least the next hour. Take a moment to enjoy it. If the world's about to end, I'm sure the Seeker will let us know.
I'm sure she will. Alright. What's up?
So, that Taventer guy sent you into the future?
Weird, right?
Every time I think I understand magic, the rules change.
I know, right? If I were a mage, I'd just throw fire at people.
That's honest.
Anyway, I hope our new friends have what it takes to close the breach. Damn thing gives me a headache just looking at it.
Me too, buddy. Me too. Alright. What do you have to say, mister?
There was never going to be an easy answer to the mage dilemma. What you did for the mages took courage. You gave them a chance. Everyone deserves one.
Thanks, dude. I appreciate the support.
And what are we supposed to do, exactly?
What you always do, complain.
We've already spoken with Commander Cullen. No one listens. We want better quarters. We want the Templars kept at a distance. And some respect for...
This is not the Circle. You mages are our allies, not our wards. Act like it.
How are we supposed to...
deal with it? It never ends, evidently.
Yep. Speaking the truth,
you don't
Seeker.
Need to tell me that.
I just don't know who told them I'm the one to yell at.
Is it that bad?
The mages are here as equals. They need to get used to what that means. It is your doing, after all. You created this alliance.
I just hope it's gonna work out.
Well, I hope it works. What other choice do we have?
Oh. I do sound like I'm blaming you, don't I? I don't disapprove. In fact, you did well. You made a decision when it needed to be made. And here we are. I wish I could say this was my doing.
I am pretty clever.
We wouldn't be here at all if you hadn't stood up against the Chantry.
You're being kind.
You're discounting your role in this.
Let's close the breach. Then we can say how successful I was.
Alright.
The mages are ready to approach the breach. I pray this will be enough to close it.
Would you be more confident if I brought back Templars instead?
I'd be less worried about the thin veil resulting in mass possession. I will not endanger the alliance you've created. We need their help. Any precautions taken will be to ensure the safety of our people and the mages themselves. Nothing more.
Is there anything I should know?
I'm glad to have the charges on our side. Fool's men are professionals, despite evidence to the contrary.
That's all for now.
If you require anything, I'll be here.
Good deal. About all.
It is good to be surrounded by mages again. Inhale. And paint. Crackle of magic. Smell of old books.
What do you have to say for yourself, Liliana?
Blackwall knows nothing about the disappearance of the Grey Wardens. It's a disappointment. I am, however, glad that he is with us. Even if he was not what I expected. He seems to be a good man, and his experience will be an asset to the Inquisition. As for the other Wardens, I suppose we will have to keep looking.
In Redcliffe, you sacrificed yourself so that I could return here.
Of course I did. One small life in exchange for a second chance at history. I always loved a bargain.
It was still a sacrifice, and still noble.
And I would do it again.
You seem to know a great many people.
I have made friends, and on occasion enemies. It's unavoidable.
They say you spent some time in Lothering. Did you know the champion?
We spoke a few times. I seldom left the Chantry, and we never became more than casual acquaintances. I saw more of the Hawk twins. Bethany in particular. She would spend time in meditation at the Chantry. And she seemed to like my stories. The other one, the young man. He was a little surly. I did encounter the champion again later in Kirkwall. Those were terrible times.
Was this when the Chantry was destroyed?
No, that happened later. But even then, the news coming out of Kirkwall was disheartening. There were some in Valrayo who wanted the Divine to declare an exalted march on Kirkwall. Justina sent me there to see if that could be avoided, to gather evidence to calm those agitating for war. I guess it didn't matter in the end.
You have a history with the Warden who ended the Blight, don't you?
She's always in my thoughts. Even when we're far apart, my love is on a quest of her own. When the Inquisition has no further need of me, I will join her. For good this time. I have lost enough. I will not lose her as well.
You seem to know Josephine quite well.
I met her a long time ago, but we didn't become good friends until years later. After the Blight, in fact. I'd just returned to Valrayu, and she welcomed me back by throwing a diplomatic ball. She was the Antivan ambassador at the time, you see. The ball was... all right. Too many politicians. At midnight, Josie and I left to find a real party. We've been friends ever since.
A real party?
What do you consider a real party?
It's not a real party until someone's small clothes are pinned to a chantry board. And that's all I'm saying about it.
Oh my.
We can continue this conversation later.